Hey there, measurement ladies and gentlemen! In this video, we'll talk about one of the most important GA4 metrics, and that is conversion rate. So let's dive into it. We have some fantastic news here. Now you can view conversion rate directly in standard reports in GA4. And you might be watching this video somewhere in the future because we have our Measure Summit coming, and this is why it is published a bit later, but I am recording it exactly on the day when I saw the conversion rate metric is available in standard reports. And this is awesome, not only for your data analysis, but even the fact, the very fact that Google seems to hear us and addresses our issues that are important. Great. I really appreciate that. So let's go to reports. And this is my traffic acquisition report. And I know people are really excited about the news and they were trying to find the conversion rate in their reports. But the thing is, if you go to your report, you would not be able to see this metric here. Let me actually click on this arrow symbol just to expand this one. And the reason for that is that you have to add it manually. And here you have this pencil and you can customize your report so you can play with the reporting interface. And let's say I want to add new metrics here, add metric. And here we go. I need my conversion rate. And this is where we have session conversion rate as well as user conversion rate. Things might be getting a bit confusing, but don't worry, we will cover it. Let me pull them just a bit up so that we can find those immediately. I would put them right here. Now let's click apply. And here we go. So now you can see session conversion rate as well as user conversion rate. And here we have different numbers. Why is it so? So user conversion rate is exactly the percentage of users who converted, whereas the session conversion rate shows you the percentage of sessions in which any conversion event took place. It might be still a bit confusing, so let's have a look at it in more detail. And here we go. You can see two users that initiated three sessions each. And the first user converted in both sessions, whereas the second user did not have any conversions. Let's have a look at the formula. So this is how we can calculate session conversion rate. Sessions with any conversion event divided by the total number of sessions. And now let's do a bit of math here. Who can guess the correct session conversion rate in this case? Yeah, this is exactly 33.34%. Voila. But let's have a look at the same situation, but we are looking now at user conversion rate. So we are considering our users, and this is the formula, users who triggered any conversion event divided by total number of users. And here we go. This is our user conversion rate. So the first user converted two times, but it doesn't matter in this case. It is important for us to know that this is a converted user and the second one is unconverted user, so to say. And this is why our user conversion rate is 50%. Okay, so this is how you can view those metrics in standard reports. And the cool thing is that you can also use the dropdown here and you can have a look at specific events. Let's say I want to look at my purchase. Unfortunately, I don't have much data flowing because this is a test property of your search results. And here we go. You can see the percentage. So I think it is great because now you can analyze specific events. And this is how you can work with the conversion rate in your standard reports. But we can also dive deeper into data and we can work with this metric in the explorations. Hey there, are you a GA4 expert? Do you want to prove it in a fun way? We have prepared something for you, a competition. So under this video, you can find a link to the form. And if you guess 7 GA4 features correctly, we have some awesome prizes for you. Measure School t-shirts. And in 2 weeks, we will announce the winners in one of the upcoming videos or in the comments section. So have fun and good luck. So let's go data explorations, and I will switch to a demo account provided by Google because they have some data flowing to their property. And let's go to the Explorer section, and I will create a new exploration. And here we go. Let's provide name, conversion rate, and I will add my dimension. I want to look at session source medium. Let's add this one, and let's add the metrics as well. So total users. You don't have to exit actually sessions. Here are my sessions. Then I want to have conversions. Here we go. Then we have user conversion rate and session conversion rate. And let's import those. Fantastic. And let's build our report. And I will simply double click. Oh, I absolutely love this functionality. Or you can also drag and drop, but I prefer double clicking. So convenient. And here we go. We have our report, and you can see user conversion rate as well as session conversion rate. And this is absolutely normal that user conversion rate is higher, right? Because let's say one user had multiple sessions, let's say 6 sessions, but this user converted only in 1 session. And this user will be considered a converted user. And the number of those unconverted sessions would not impact this rate anyhow. Yeah, whereas session conversion rate is looking at sessions. It fully depends on your case, what you want to analyze, but it is important to understand the difference between these metrics. And again, I think this is amazing news that we have also this metric available in standard reports. So now you know where to find the conversion rate, both in the standard reports as well as in explorations. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, and you can check other GA4 videos right here. And see you next time. Happy measuring!